Hi everyone and welcome back. It's been a long time. I was focusing on other things. I hope you're all enjoying the summer. Here in Spain we've been enjoying a heat wave. Enjoying is probably too big a word for what we've been doing. We've been sweating our tits off is what we've been doing. So it is so humid today. Gotta drink some water. On the bright side, I've got good at actually keeping my plants alive and propagating them. Look at this one. Look at this one. I can show you my monsteras. Monsteras, I've got multiple now. Today we're making three dips. We're gonna be making a roasted garlic hummus, lots of like nice golden brown cloves of garlic. We're gonna be making a butterbean white bean dip. You can use white beans if you don't like butterbeans. And we're gonna be making a sun-dried tomato tapenade with green olives, yum! Those are my favorite dips at the moment. And to be fair, I usually have about five favorite dips cycling at a time. Dips are where it's at. Dips, salsas, whatever, my fave. So, let's get to it. This is an apron that says Hamburitas Kitchen. Going to start with is rehydrating the sun-dried tomatoes. You can also just get sun-dried tomatoes on oil. They usually have some nice bits in there like garlic, herbs. They didn't have them at the shop that I go to, so I got these dehydrated ones. They work just as fine. All you have to do, I've just boiled some water, so I'm just going to pour that over. And then let that sit whilst we start doing and prepping the other stuff. Then before you get rid of the kettle, I will take some paper towels, you can't see this, and wet them slightly. And then when you put your chopping board on top of this, no sliding. Right, cheers. Next we're going to move on to some garlic. First we're going to peel a couple of these so we can get whole cloves, and we're going to confit those, which is just a fancy word, not a fancy word, a French word for candying. It just means slowly cooking them in oil. So we're going to take 1, 2, 3, 4 bulbs, 4 heads of garlic for the confit. And then we'll take a couple of additional ones for putting in the hummus fresh. And we're gonna very quickly make a little garlic oil as well. So get those heads of garlic ready. We're gonna start by peeling all 4 of these. I have a little trick if you wanna peel a lot of garlic in one go. You put it in a container or a plate with a bowl with a plate on top, and you just aggressively shake. They don't all come off at once, but they do come off. All right, we've peeled the garlic. I'm gonna take a little pot and some oil. This is olive oil. And then we're gonna add the garlic and the oil in the pot, and we're gonna put it on a low heat and let that simmer until we're pleased with the result, until they're about golden brown. So I'm gonna do that and do a little cleanup in between because everything's covered in garlic peels. Okay, whilst the garlic is on, we're gonna take the sun-dried tomatoes and we're gonna take some green olives. just one little clove of garlic and some lemon juice and oil, and we're gonna make the tapenade, and we're gonna leave that for when we're ready to have all our dips at once. So I'm gonna just strain the sun-dried tomatoes, and then I'm gonna also strain some of the olives, and we'll combine them in the food processor. If you don't have one of these, you can also do it in a blender, or you can use like a handheld mixer as well. Should not be a problem. Olives and tomatoes. I'd say I've got about 2 cups of each here, which I think will equate to maybe 200-250 grams of the tomatoes and 200-250 grams of the olives. You can adjust the ratios to your liking. This is a very flexible recipe, which, if you know me, you know I like a flexible recipe. You really don't have to do everything exactly as I say. If you don't like olives, you don't have to put in olives. What about that? So yeah, we'll put those in the food processor. Got lemon. I'm gonna start with half a lemon and then taste it and then see if I want to add more lemon. I encourage you to do the same, because I might say put half a lemon, but then my lemon might be a lot smaller, a lot bigger than your lemon. Again, go trust your taste buds. Trust your taste buds. It's okay to trust them. You like what you know, and you know what you like. So I am going to put that together, and we'll come back when it's blended. Right, so we've got everything in the food processor. Let's go. You ready? A little bit more oil, because I can see the consistency is not yet where I want it to be. This is a very fancy olive oil that my dad gave me from someone's olive garden, friends of his. Okay, next up, we're gonna make the butter bean dip, or white bean dip if you've chosen white beans, that's also fine. I love butter beans, they're so creamy, the texture is amazing. So we're gonna take the butter beans, I'm gonna go strain them and wash them, and we're gonna take another clove of garlic. I feel like I need the audio. I am a garlic girl. Anyway, I'm gonna take one of these. I'm gonna use some tahini. We're gonna need some olive oil. We're gonna use some more lemon juice, and we're also gonna get some salt and some pepper. Butter beans rinsed. Love. Blender. I'm using the blender for hummus. This kind of dip, because it just gets you the smoothest results. Butter beans go in. Garlic. I'm gonna do some lemon. I actually have a little cut on one of my fingers, so this is not a pleasant experience. Then tahini. That's my attempt at pronouncing it. So I like adding a lot. How much would that be? A third cup? 100 mils? 100 grams? Something along those lines. So we're gonna add some salt in this lovely, my friend gave this to me from Morocco. Pinch of salt. I realize I'm out of pepper, so no pepper today. I'm gonna get some cold water. Okay, splash of oil. About a tablespoon-ish, I would say. And then I have this adorable, oops, a little one person picture that I got from the charity shop. I'm gonna just do splash of water. And then we're gonna blend and see if we like the consistency, and if not, we're gonna alter accordingly. Right, let's have a look. A little taste. I'm gonna do the very tiniest splash of water. It's got such a strong flavor of the tahini, which I really like, and then with the lemon and a little bit of salt and the beans, I love it. I think the tahini should be quite present. Whenever I've had food at like a Lebanese style restaurant, places where they know how to properly make hummus, I always feel like the tahini is very, very present in the flavor and in the texture, and that's where it gets the really good, the very smooth, creamy texture from. Whereas when you can tell, I find in Spain, there's a lot of places, unfortunately, where the hummus isn't made very well, and there is maybe a tiny little splash of tahini in there, and it just, the texture's not right. It's not right for me. Anyway, let's blend this one more time, and then I think we're done. Yes, that is it. Let's have a look. Okay, the white bean dip is done. I'm gonna cover it and put it in the fridge for a bit, and we'll come back to it when it's time. The garlic is also done, the confit garlic, so we're gonna move on to making our hummus with the confit garlic in. So we're gonna scoop out the garlic and save the delicious garlic oil for something else. So I'm gonna strain the chickpeas for the hummus and put this in the fridge, and then we'll start on the hummus. Alright, first let's get this amazing garlic oil. I've got about 6 of the confit garlic here, and I'm going to leave them to the side. And the rest of them are going to go in to the blender, where I will also be adding the chickpeas for the hummus. So we'll take that oil and put it to the side for a sec. Chickpeas go in. Again, some lemon juice. I use this thingy to save my hands. And because we've got about a whole head, minimum whole head of confit garlic, I don't think it's necessary to add more garlic. We'll add a pinch of salt for some oil. Splash, I think about a teaspoon of regular oil, and then we'll do another teaspoon of the confit garlic oil. Then tahini, again about 100 grams, don't be shy. Like a quarter cup, I don't really know, just don't be shy. Get in there with tahini. And then in the end, we'll add another splash of ice cold water. I put 2 ice cubes in here. And then we'll blend, check for consistency, and adjust accordingly. Consistency perfect. I'm gonna blend it one more time, and then blend that one more time, and then we'll put it into a nice bowl. Done. Put it in the fridge for a bit. Now, if I look shiny, that's because I am sweaty. We're almost done. We're almost done. We're gonna do one more little thing. I'm gonna take some of the confit garlic oil, about half of it, like 3 tablespoons. And we're gonna heat that up really hot. And then we're gonna take about 3 cloves of garlic. This video should be called an ode to garlic, clearly. Just mince these cloves of garlic while the oil gets nice and hot. Right, that should do it. That is the minced garlic. I'm gonna wait for that to get even more hot. In the meantime, I have these other cloves of garlic from the confit garlic that I took to the side. I'm just gonna kind of chop them. They're very soft. They should come apart as you slice into them. Don't put them with the other garlic. That's that. I'm gonna get a little bowl for the garlic oil. So in your little bowl, you're gonna add the freshly minced garlic and a pinch of salt. And then you could add a little bit of paprika here. I don't have any, even a little smoked paprika if you fancy. Some crushed chilies would be good in this as well. We're just gonna keep it simple for the sake of simplicity. This oil is now nice and hot. So we're gonna turn the stove off. And then I'm gonna pour the hot oil onto the garlic. That's the noise we're looking for. Okay, that's it, we're done. We made it. So we've got our sun-dried tomato olive tapenade. We've got a roasted garlic, confit garlic hummus. And we've got a lovely white bean hummus dip. What we're gonna do is assemble them, and we're gonna add the freshly made garlic oil with the fresh garlic. That's a bit more zingy because it's got that freshness. I'm gonna add that onto the white bean dip. Then I'm gonna put some leftover confit garlic oil with some of the confit garlic on top of the hummus, and maybe just a tiny splash of oil to make the tapenade also look even more appealing. And then we'll be back for a little bit of tasting. Okay, amigos, it is time for the taste test. Get comfortable. I've got some homemade sourdough. Let's start with the tapenade. I should get a little spoon for this. Okay, now let's start with the tapenade. That's good. That is nice. It's got the nice saltiness that you get from olives, sun-dried tomato. I love the taste of sun-dried tomato. I actually think I normally make it with a bigger ratio of sun-dried tomato to olive, which I think is my favorite. But this is great. Okay, which one should we do next? White bean dip? Let's do white bean dip. The texture is so good, it is so smooth. Mm-hmm. And then you get that little bit of fresh garlic on top with some oil. It's great. All right, now let's try the confit garlic hummus. I'm gonna put some hummus. I'm gonna put some extra. When you get confit garlic, it's just so, it's got that sweetness, a little bit of that garlicky flavor, but also like umami enhancer. And the texture of this hummus, I don't know if you can see this, but the texture is amazing. Let's have one more go at this hummus. Banger. And a little bit of that. A little bit of that. Mm-hmm. All right, folks. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this one. Planning to come back with more videos. I've got some good ideas. So give it a like, subscribe, all those things. Let me know if you make one of these. These are fabulous just to have in the fridge for your own sandwiches or carrot sticks or whatever. Also great for barbecue. Just saying, it's summer, you know? All right.